educate the people who run it, the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all. There's a time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part, you can't even passively take part, and you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers.
Well, hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. You know, I didn't think I'd be coming back to you tonight. It's quite late, after midnight. And I thought the last video I put out with the confirmation from the Intel Hub that we are under martial law was enough. And then I had to check my email and come across this post from the PAC Alert... PAC Alert Press, excuse me. Apologize for butchering that. It's a great resource. This headline, I didn't think could wait till morning. There's too many sheep out there, and there are too many executive orders that have been written. Obama has signed 923 executive orders in 40 months. That's right. I'm going to read from the Post now. What did Congress do in those 40 months? Executive Order 10990 allows the government to take over all modes of transportation and control of highways and seaports. Executive Order 10995 allows the government to seize and control the communication media. Executive Order 10997 allows the government to take over all electrical power, gas, petroleum, fuels, and minerals. Executive Order 10998 allows the government to take over all food resources and farms. Executive Order 11000 allows the government to mobilize civilians into work brigades under government supervision. Executive Order 11001 allows the government to take over all health, education, and welfare functions. Executive Order 11002 designates thereof all persons, Postmaster General, to operate a national registration. Executive Order 11003 allows the government to take over all airports and aircraft, including commercial aircraft. Executive Order 11004 allows the Housing and Finance Authority to relocate communities, build new housing with public funds, designate areas to be abandoned, and establish new locations for populations. Good Lord. Executive Order 11005 allows the government to take over railroads, inland waterways, and public storage facilities. Executive Order 11049 assigns emergency preparedness functions to federal departments and agencies, consolidating 21 operative executive orders issued over 15-year period. Executive Order 11051 specifies the responsibility of the Office of Emergency Planning and gives authorization to put all executive orders into effect in times of increased international tensions and economic or financial crisis. Executive Order 11310 grants authority to the Department of Justice to enforce the plan set out in executive orders, to institute industrial support, to establish judicial and legislative liaisons, to control all aliens, to operate penal and correctional institutions, and to advise and assist the President. Executive Order 11921 allows the Federal Emergency Preparedness Agency to develop plans, establish control over the mechanisms of production and distribution of energy sources, wages, salaries, credit, and the flow of money in the United States financial institution in any undefined national emergency. It also provides that when a state emergency is declared by the President, Congress cannot review the action for 6 months. Now, there's more in this post I'm going to link you below, because if you don't do a little bit of the research, then, well, quite honestly, you deserve to end up in one of these FEMA camps, because you all got to give a little bit, but I'll bring it to you. Take my word for it. If you want to argue the point, do it after you've done some research. Much love. Be safe. Thanks to the PAC Alert Press for this information. Link to the post will be below.